Hey everyone, coming on with another Mercury video here. I've got my new stereo for it. If you watched my video about the cassette deck that won't play tapes, ended up being a broken belt, and I'm not going to be able to find one for an aftermarket deck like that. It's just not going to happen. So instead of trying to find another aftermarket deck to put under the dash, I figured, what the hell? Why not just buy an under dash cassette player that's just the tape deck alone, so I don't have to deal with a radio as well. That way I can just have a tape deck and I can still use the radio that's in the car, and I'll just, you know, have a cassette tape deck to play my tapes mounted underneath the dash. And I was actually very lucky to find this realistic brand stereo cassette deck. It's not auto reverse because it's too old for that, but it's new old stock. This thing, the tape was broken when I got it, obviously, because the seller on eBay had to take it out of the box to, you know, show pictures of it. But it's new old stock. The original price tag is on it somewhere here. And yeah, there's not much else to tell about that. So I want to do a little video of me unboxing this here to show you what it comes with. And what's nice about it is that, so it's got, includes all the speaker cables and mounting hardware, so I don't have to deal with fabricating anything. It's all in this little kit, and it, you know, people say universal things are actually never universal, but with old stuff like this, it's pretty much universal. So I mean, I might have to deal with a little bit of weirdness trying to get it to go on. I was already looking at how the ashtray is in a really bad spot, but let's see what we got here. So, speaker wires, and of course it's got these old school connectors in there. I don't know what you call those. They don't make it like that anymore though, with the rubber on the outsides. So speakers there, or wires there, and then this. Look at that thing, huh? Custom manufactured for Radio Shack. That's crazy. You know you're getting old when you're buying stuff from a company that doesn't exist anymore, right? So yeah, look at that. It's got, what do you think that's actually got? You think that still applies? Yeah, here you go. Just the directions of how everything works and how you're supposed to mount it and all that stuff. It's pretty cool, and you can even get a diagram. What more can you ask for? And guess what? This thing was $60, new old stock. $60 working. Well, I don't know if it actually works or not, but it should. It hasn't been messed with. So let me get this out of the box here, and I'll show you what it looks like. I've never actually seen it in person. All right, what do we got? Look at this. This is a receipt. Holy cow! This is cool, man. This is old stuff. It's history. Like Gibbstown, New Jersey. $35. Wow. What a cool piece of history here. Purchased on July 29th, 1985. That's pretty cool. Look at this. The Radio Shack receipt from 1985. And it's like looking brand new too. That's pretty cool. I'm gonna keep this. All right, what have we got here? This must be for the mounting hardware. Okay. Look at that. Oh man, this thing is neat. Look at that. That is cool as shit, man. This is just a cool thing. New old stock. Look at this thing. It's brand spanking new out of the box. 1985. Let's see if I can get this to sit so I can show you here. Look at that. All the knobs and shit are in good shape. The doors. I mean, man, that's just, it is not mechanical though. This feels like a button and not a lever, so that is dangerous for, you know, tapes can get stuck in your player a lot easier with when you don't have a mechanical eject, when it's a computer or not a computer, a electric eject. When you push this and it just sends an electrical impulse to hit, to force the thing to eject, it might not want to sometimes if the tape gets eaten. So that isn't good. But look at this. Got your volume slider thing. Hopefully it goes loud enough for my liking. Balance. Tone. I don't even know what that means, but it's there. Their red light for, actually, I don't know what the red light's for. I think it's just for, you know, shows that it's on or that it's active playing a tape. This. So I guess you're supposed to plug in these wires to the back of this deal here, and the ground goes to the ground, and the rest is history. So yeah, that's pretty cool. I'm definitely gonna install this. I'm gonna try to do it tonight, but it's already, you know, past dinner time, and I haven't even eaten yet. And then I'm actually gonna be looking at a car tomorrow, so I'm gonna be out of town. I'm not gonna be able to work on stuff for the first part of the day, so yeah, I'll have to read the instructions and see where I'm at with what I'm supposed to do about this. But that's what it looks like. And then here, I don't know exactly where I'm gonna put this yet, but I'm thinking, so normally you'd say put it right here, right underneath the radio and climate control, so you can get to it easy, because obviously it's not going to go over there, and if you put it all the way over there, well, you can't, because the glove box is there. But the problem is, here, this ashtray pulls out, so, you know, you're not going to be able to get your, the whole thing comes with it. So where you'd normally mount this, it would come with it when you went to smoke a cigarette. So you can't, you can't mount it there. There is this piece right here that doesn't move with the ashtray. It's just part of the dash. But if you mount it right here, that son of a bitch is going to be all the way underneath. I mean, imagine driving this thing and trying to change a tape while you're driving, and you got to reach all the way down here to get to it. It just seems like a pain, but I think that it's going to end up having to be where it's going to go, because there's no other place for it to go on this, because the goddamn trailer brakes are on the way over here, not that I want to put it over here anyway, and then the glove box, you know, comes down all the way that way, so you're not going to be putting it anywhere else. It's got to go right there. But yeah, I'll see what I see when I go to install it, and then after I do and I test it and everything, I'll put a cool little video out for you guys if you're interested. So yeah, I'll see you then.